Down from Jerusalem to Jericho, fell among thieves that stripped him of his raiment and wounded him and departed, leaving him half dead. And by chance there came down a certain priest that way, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. Don't he didn't look at him. Likewise, a Levite, when he was at the place, came and looked on him and passed by on the other side. But a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was. And when he saw him, he had compassion on him. And went to him and bound up his wounds, pouring in oil and wine, and set him on his own beast, and brought him to an inn and took care of him. Amen. Oh, praise God. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for another day. My God, thank you for truth that will prevail. You've never forsaken the righteous. You've always been there. We thank you right now for the way you can do what you are able to do. Give you praise and glory. For everything, oh God, we love you right now in the name of Jesus. Meet needs. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Never count God out. Right. Amen. It may not be your agenda that he's on, but don't count him out. Right. What he has got planned for you far exceeds the circumstance that you're in. The word passion defined means the degree of difficulty we are willing to endure to accomplish the goal that we have. Passion conveys the gritty determination that we're going to finish the task that is at hand. You do not have to be beautiful. You do not have to be rich. You don't have to be handsome. You don't have to have a high IQ. Amen. You don't have to come from the finest family. Instead, you need to just be set on fire for the purpose of God. That's all he wants out of your life. We are a people on a mission. We're not just fishing. Amen. It's time we realize we've got a host, the Holy Ghost. Amen. We need a weeping zone in the church. And when you give God all, he becomes all. When you don't give him all, he's not all in your life. And then you start blaming him, but he turns around and says, look, I'll give you everything like that father gave the prodigal elder or the elder son. I'll give you everything. In April 2000, Ruby Allison and Laura Edwards were killed in Cameroon, West Africa. Ruby was over 80 years of age, single all her life, gave her life for the mission work to reach the poor and the sick. Laura, her co-worker, was a widow, a medical doctor, nearly 80 herself. Brakes failed in their automobile, went over a cliff, both of them killed instantly. Now, was that a tragedy? Two lives driven by great passion to be spent in unheralded service for the perishing poor, for the glory of God, even after their 60s, two decades, 20 years later, they're still not retired and not trifling their life away. No, that was not a tragedy on that day. It was a glory. These lives were not wasted. Amen. Their lives were not lost. Amen. 80 years for the glory of God. Mark 8:35, whosoever will save his life will lose it, Jesus said. Whosoever protects themselves from doing what they ought to do will kill and lose their life. But whoever loses, gives everything to Jesus for his sake, they're gonna live. Hallelujah. I don't want to be dead weight in the yoke of God. I'm telling you tonight, desperation and passion and compassion is a lost commodity among a lot of our people. But desperate people, they don't allow protocol or somebody's opinion or the image they might keep or the ego to stop them. Can you say amen? Amen.
Hallelujah.
Now, what most people want is the American dream in America. Take an early retirement from their job. She's 60 or he's 60, she's 55. Move to Florida. Get a 30-foot boat. She likes to collect seashells. He likes to still play softball. Hey man, can you get this picture? Hey man, when they're before Christ on the judgment day of the righteous, and the Lord says, what do you got to show me? I've got some seashells. Hey, I hit a lot of home runs. Companies in America spend billions of dollars to track people, to persuade them to embrace this tragic dream of giving up. My God, don't waste your life. Don't get caught up in the system. Don't live in the fatal success. But let your life become successful in the significance that we have given everything to God. Don't coast along the way and have to be pushed and pumped and primed. We need desperation and passion in this last day. Say amen.
Amen.
Arthur Scoopin Hall said, the greatest accomplishments are only achieved through vehement, violent, passionate will called desperation. He said it's what separates the champion from the contender and the winner from the loser, and that which would be fulfilled and that which would be frustrated. Amen. You can't go to heaven on mama's apron string and daddy's coattail. My God, we need to do all we can while we can. As the church, we need a divine interruption in our daily life, a transformational interruption that changes us. Amen. For the God calls that he wants us to have. We cannot just go to church, show up, wait on the preacher to stir us. We need a drive in our soul. Amen. The Holocaust was a horrible thing. The tragedy of the Holocaust in Auschwitz, Germany, was 6 million were murdered. It's more troubling when you visit the museum there than just being told about it or read about it. They say when you actually go there and see the gates, the fence, the chambers, the ovens, and see thousands of shoes that's lined up, small adult children, see them shoes, a place where people were marked not by names and by faces, they were marked by tattooed numbers. Amen. But the statistic that is only really a reality, because there were 6 million names and there were 6 million faces who wore those shoes. And we want to say sometimes, God, where was the church in that day? Lord, where was the voice for this injustice? Where was the people of God during that time? Amen. Even in our day, right now, 2014, rushing in toward 2015, posters of missing children. Some of their names are the names of your children. And it strikes you when you see that. Human trafficking going on in America. Amen. It's like seeing the shoes of Auschwitz all over again, because these children, they're not numbers. They're not just posters. They're not just statistics. They are somebody's daughter.
There are somebody's son. There are somebody's sister and somebody's classmate. But human trafficking is a world problem to watch on. Amen. In our generation, the current state of slavery has flourished in the dark rooms of our world, with all of our churches, all of our revivals, all of our camp meetings, conventions, worships, all of our resources. There are still more slaves on the earth than there's ever been before. Amen. It's time to get desperate. It's time to say, I gotta do more than what I've been doing.
Amen.
Oh, God. In our text, the man is wounded, left half dead. The Bible said, the priest passed by. The Levite looked on him, but passed by. But only the Samaritan came where he was and had compassion on him. The Levite and the priest, they had sentiment, but that's all they had. That Samaritan had the compassion, and compassion interrupts us, and it inspires us into action, gives us that drive we need. Are we like the Levite and the priest today? We're always in a hurry. We miss a couple Wednesdays a month. We're too busy. We're going to the next event. We're involved in this over here. Are we going to the cross, the road? Are we going to get this man that's laying there half dead? Is this man to us like the Levite and priest a distraction and not the object of what we ought to be doing? Are we hurting people, amen, in this life because of our ignorance of what we ought to do and ignoring them? Are hurting people with names and faces, amen, or are they just a pair of empty shoes? 27 million slaves in the world as we speak tonight. I'm telling you, there's something we've got to do. There's more that we've got to do.
How much time do we give God? 168 hours in a week. How much time does God get out of that 168 hours? Oh, Lord. A rescued victim named Sonia told how she was shipped to Istanbul in a container with 60 other girls. During the trip, the oxygen tank broke and the crate was opened, and 30 already suffocated and 30 survived. The 30 that survived were locked in an apartment, and they were molested several times a day by men wearing law enforcement uniforms. En route later by boat to Athens, they were spotted by the Coast Guard, and then they threw these women overboard. 25 drowned and 5 survived, and Sonia was one of the 5 that survived. You see, we're not lacking God's will. We're not lacking the knowledge of God. We're not lacking, amen, a desire. We got a desire. We lack real desperation that says, I must touch God. I must put more of my life into God. So we look at the drug dealer today. He puts us to shame in what he's doing and where he's at. The drinker of alcohol who will do anything and hawk the living room furniture to get another drink. The professional college ball teams have this last moment play, a do or die desperate position they're at. We must look, amen, at the clock and say, God, what time is it for me to wake up and see where I need to be? We're out of time. The end is upon us. The hourglass sand is about out. We're racing the rapture. We cannot pay attention to Hollywood, the media, the newscast. They're cursed and they're doomed. Hey, amen. We've got to wake up and realize
Everywhere we go, all over America, and all of our churches, we are completely spoiled. That's where we're at. We're spoiled. I mean, we got Walmart down the road. We got a bank here. We're spoiled. We're involved. We go here. We got two cars. We got air conditioning. Amen. And this and that. I'm telling you, we're spoiled. And that has hindered our action for God to do more than we ever have done. Our own nation is borrowing money to get out of debt. Amen. Some of us right now would put our sickness in the hands of a surgical procedure. That's a 50-50 chance just to make it, but we would do it. Amen. Knowing that we could die, but when you become desperate enough, amen, it doesn't matter. That's what we gotta get. God, get me desperate. Desire is good, but it's only initial emotion. Amen. Desire needs to kick in. Amen. In the place where we are desperate. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Like that woman with the issue of blood. 12 years bleeding. 4,380 sunrises and still hemorrhaging. 4,380 sunsets and still bleeding. Ran out of money, ran out of time, ran out of options. The doctors took every dime that she had. Listen to me. You believe and have faith, and you just need to get desperate. We know what to do, but we're just not getting that extra fuel to do it. Like in Matthew 8, that leper running up the hill meets Jesus, who is his virtue. Now he's deaf nearly, but he's met life. He is in impurity, but he has met purity. He wasn't full of faith. The Bible says just a grain of mustard seed of faith, but he was full of compassion and desperate. Amen. The lost straw, the last straw was there. The end of his rope, the knot was there. It was a make it or break it moment. Urgency is always the fuel that fires desperate people, and they carry on and they go on. We love God, but we're lacking the passion and the persistence that we've got to have. Desperate folks, they do desperate things, and that's where we got to get to. Lord, get me desperate. Don't let me just come to church and wait on 9 o'clock, Lord. Don't let me just come to church and just come and wait on somebody to shove it and push it and go. When Jehoshaphat ran out of options, he went to God, and God was another world that he stepped into. Jonah got desperate. He got sick of that, the stomach acids of that whale. Amen. Blubber hotel, I call it. Self-made prison, that water taxi he got in. Amen. Seaweed at the bottom of the ocean. He wasn't praying, "Now I lay me down to sleep." He wasn't praying in that stomach of that whale. I probably want a cracker prayer. I'll tell you what the Bible said. He said, "Then I sought the Lord." He didn't just pray, he sought. When I lose my pen, I look for it. When I lose a piece of paper, I search for it. When I need something from God, I seek. My God, I need to saw him. I need to call on him. Our missing ingredient is desperation. As long as you have an option, you'll never get desperate. As long as you've got another road to travel, you'll never get compassion. As long as you've got, amen, another way to manage, you'll never do the right thing. It's time to wake up and say, "God, I want you to be Lord of my life."
Amen.
Everybody wants a Savior. Everybody wants saved. Everybody wants healed. Everybody wants this. You just think about it every time you get down to pray. Most of your prayer is, God, I need. Lord, I want you to do this. God, I got this problem. Lord, we seldom worship. We seldom worship. We're always asking, always begging, always pleading. I know what I'm talking about. Amen. That's what's going on. But the next time you pray tonight, come up here 5 minutes and pray. Just worship. Say, God, I'm not here for you to give me anything. I just want to worship. I just want to magnify you. You will feel the difference. I said, you will feel the difference. Amen. That rich young ruler had a desire, but that wasn't enough. He walked away. If you don't give all, you cannot receive all. Remember that Gadaran, naked, 2,000 devils in him. Guess what? The only ones that was desperate in that story, amen, was the devils. The devils were more desperate than the disciples. Because the Bible said, Jesus asked, what is thy name? He said, my name is Legion. And verse 10, the Bible said, and he besought the Lord much, even though he had them devils in him. And here's a devil asking for prayer requests. Amen. He got desperate. Verse 12, and all the devils besought him. The devils got desperate and the people didn't. And Jesus answered the devil's prayer request. Think about it. They wanted the swine. Get us into the pigs. Desperation can stop hell. Put the devil on the brakes. Desperation can stop death. It can design things you need. It can bring defeat to the enemy. It can build a bridge, amen, for the miraculous to cross into. Desperation can unite faith and facts and situations and a savior. I love it when desperation shows up. And the examination, I told you of a night, the doctor said, we've done three of them. There's nothing there. And that PhD, 15 years of college, has to say it's a higher power. There's something greater than what I've done. That's all I can tell you. Amen. Desperation brings destinies to an altar and to a place. Say amen. When you're out of answers, you go to Jesus. Just like Jairus. He brought his dead daughter to Jesus. My. Dead. You know what he did? First thing he did with a dead daughter in his arms? Worshipped Jesus before he said anything.
Think about it.
Oh, my. Oh. If you need something from God, he's always found at his feet. You can find him. You may be in a fiery furnace, but oh, the fourth man's gonna show up. You may be in a jail cell, but the heavenly earthquake is going to arrive. Napoleon, one time losing a battle, he yelled out for the bugle boy. And he told the bugle boy, blow the retreat signal. I love this. The bugle boy said, I've never learned the retreat signal. Amen. We don't have to reverse. We don't have to go in neutral. We don't have to spin our tires. When you get desperate, the devil's got to back up. And the glory of God's going to move in. And you're able to go to church the next time and give the praise report. Hallelujah. Whatever your personal challenge is tonight, whatever your family trial might be, or your economic circumstance, or the weary, tiresome soul, it is desperation that will take care of you. When you're caving in, amen, when you are about to go down, you need more than a little talk with Jesus. You need more than a little dive into you. My God,
You need to say, Lord, I am desperate and I'm believing you, God, that you can do anything in my life.
That's right. That's right.
Oh, God. We've got to exceed the 11th hour. We've got to shove this thing into overtime. Help me here with a song, please. Amen. Are we going to get desperate when something tragic happens? That's not the time. The time to get desperate before that day ever arrives. And you get prepared for what's going to happen. Amen. A.M. Wood became a preacher. Before he was ever a preacher, of course, he was a Christian. But his wife, she was not. She left him a note. And she committed suicide. And in that note she said, I'm not worthy to be your wife. He was so in touch with God and she didn't want to be that way that she just took her life. The tragic thing. But A.M. Wood, he joined the army. He was on a ship heading to France. Thousands of troops on that boat. All of a sudden, the ship was surrounded by German submarines, four of them. They had them trapped. And the captain asked on the bridge, who do you know that can pray? Somebody said, well, there's a Catholic priest on board, there's a Jewish rabbi, and there's a Protestant preacher. He named them off, and the captain said, listen, I know all three of those men. I've heard them curse, and I've watched them drink. He said, I want somebody to pray like my mother prayed when I was a boy. And one of the men officers said, sir, that would be A.M. Wood. I've heard him pray that very way every night at his bunk. The captain said, get that man on this bridge. They brought him up there and he looked that man eyeball to eyeball, A.M. Wood. And the captain said, son, we got four subs around us. We're going to get blown out of the water without a miracle. He said, I want you to pray right here on that bridge. And he went to his knees. And when he got on his knees, about 5 minutes of crying out to God, amen. The soldier intact looking out at the sub said, captain, the subs are turning around. They're leaving. And the captain said, my God, point this ship toward France. Hallelujah. When you get desperate, my God, he's going to come through for you. He's never forsaken us. Amen. It's not how you start the count. It's how you finish. It's how you finish. May God pour out the move of the Holy Ghost upon the church in this last day. Raise your hands and praise God. Oh, God. Help us, Jesus. Help us, God. Oh, God. Burn the church, God. Burn the church, God. Lord, get us to that place where when we face that anxiety, we face that dilemma. We face that most frustrating time, that dilemma that puts us in to a place, oh God, of helplessness. May we be desperate and ready. Call on you. Oh God. Oh God. Oh. Ah. Silamos. Oh God.
Lord, don't let me be guilty of playing church. God, don't let me be guilty of just coming to church just with emotion or mindset. Oh, God, let that heart be your heart, oh God. Stir us, oh God. The thing that you're going to regret most in your life will not be the thing that you've done you wished you hadn't done. What you will regret the most in your life will be the things you didn't do you should have done. That'll come back to haunt you. Oh, God. Amen. Sing it for me here. Sing it. Oh, let the Holy Ghost have his way right here tonight. My God of the Spirit.